Hello all. In this lecture, we will see about relations. So we will mainly see some formal and informal definitions of relations. And then we will see about characteristics of relationship. So this is a thing that we'll go through in this lecture. So you should not confuse with the earlier relationship. Now we are going to study about relational data model. So we'll be learning, we'll be focusing our theory and the practical part on relational data models. So there are various commercial databases which uses this relational model. If you take Oracle or the DB2 of IBM, Sybase, all these use this relational data model. And we have open source systems like MySQL or PostgreSQL. Database packages use this relational data model. So why do we study this? Is how that database is developed, how this MySQL is developed inside the software, what is happening, everything will come under this relational data model. So this is mainly based on the concept of relations. So we know the concept of relations in Max. So you have studied that set theory. We have a concept called relation. So the same concept is applicable in the case of database also. So our relational database software is developed based on this concept of relation. So it is a mathematical concept based on the idea of set. We have already seen this in mathematics class or the relation set theory, everything. The strength of the relational approach is that there is a formal foundation provided by the theory of relations. We have already proved all this set theory and all. So there is a formal foundation. So the relational data model is based on this set theory. So this was proposed by Dr. E.F. Code of IBM in 1970. So he proposed this model and he received this ACM Turing Award. So the ACM Turing Award is considered to be the Nobel Prize in computer science. So he got this Turing Award for this paper. He published a research paper, a relational model for large shared data banks. It was published in Communications of the ACM in June 1970. So almost all databases during those days were developed using this relational data model. And now also we use the same data model. And with some more modifications, we still use the basic concept of relations in order to develop this DBMS software. So that's why we learn more about this relational database model. So relations, these are considered to be relations. So student is considered to be a relation. So instead of, we can say this as a table, formally it is called as a relation. So course is another relation, section is another relation. So all these tables are known as relations in relational data model. So informal definitions, we first hear about informal definitions. After that, we'll come to formal definitions. So relation can be considered as a table of values. A table which contains a lot of values can be considered as a relation. Or it can be considered as a set of rows. So in a table, we have a set of rows. So it is a relation can be considered as a set of rows. Or it can be considered as a set of columns. And each row in a relation represents an entity or relationship. And each row has a value of an item or set of items that uniquely identifies that row in the table. So if we see this relation, so here student number, it is a attribute that uniquely identifies. Or if we take this thing, this is a course number, this will be unique. So it may be a single attribute or a combination of attributes that can be used to uniquely identify a particular row. So each row has a value of an item or set of items that uniquely identifies that row in the table. And sometimes row IDs, or sequential numbers are assigned to identify the rows in the table. So when we create tables and all, and by default there will be some row ID on the left hand side. If you see, there will be an additional column which consider which has some row ID numbers 1, 2, 3, like that. There will be some ID numbers also, and each column typically is called by its column name or column header, or we call it as attribute name. So each column header is known as attribute name. So these are the informal definitions. Now we will come into the formal definition of relation. So we have already seen schema. What is schema in the previous lecture? So schema of a relation is defined like this: R of A1, A2, etc., A. So this means R is a name of that relation, and A1, A2, etc. are the attributes of that relation. So this is known as a schema of a relation. So schema of relation R. So relation schema R is defined over attributes A1, A2, etc., AN. And D is called the domain of AI. So if we take, it is denoted by domain of AI. This means if we take a row, if we take a particular attribute A1, it can take only a particular set of values. So in set, you know what you mean by a domain. Domain means the set of values that is permissible. So similarly, here in relations also, we have a domain of attributes. For each attribute, there are some domain of values. So we can take only values from that domain. Then R is called the name of this relation. So R denotes the name of the relation. And degree, what do you mean by degree of a relation? So these are all formal definitions you should understand. So what is the schema? When you say schema of employee, then employee, and in brackets you will be employee ID, name, address, like that. So it will be the schema of that employee. So degree of a relation is the number of attributes N of its relation schema. So here it is of N degree. We can say there are N number of attributes, so it is of N degree. So we'll see an example. So student, so this is the schema of student relation. So this can be considered as a schema of student relation. So here student is the name of that relation, and the attributes are name, SSN, home phone, address, office phone, age, and CGPA or GPA. And we can also define like this. We can mention the data type also. So name should be string, SSN should be some string value, home phone should be string, address should be some string value, office phone number should be string or some integer value, or age should be integer, GPA, CGPA should be a real value, like that. So we can either define like this or this. So both denotes actually the schema of student. So this is known as student schema. So always remember this term schema. Schema means it's a definition of that table. So a definition of that relation. So it just denotes the definition. So it shows the name and also the various attributes in that table or in that relation. Then next is tuple. So tuple is an ordered set of values. So each row, if we are filling some data in that relation or in the table, then each row is known as a tuple. We call it as, informally we call it as row, and in formal, in relational data model, we call it as tuple. So tuple is an ordered set of values. So there will be a particular order in tuples. So for example, if we have a customer relation, so this is a schema of customer. So we have customer ID, customer name, address, and phone number. Then a tuple will be like this. So this is an ordered set of values because it is in this order. So the customer ID, so 632895 denotes the customer ID. Then John Smith denotes his customer name, and this one denotes the address, and this one denotes the phone number. So it is an order. So this is known as a tuple of that relation. Okay, so this is a relation schema, and this is a tuple. So tuple is an ordered set of values. Informally, we can call it as a row of that relation or row of that table. So a relation can be considered as a set of tuples or set of rows also. Okay, so set of tuples. So tuple denotes rows. So remember these terms always. And columns in a table are also called attributes of the relation. So column, so customer ID, it's a column name. So this denotes the attribute name. Customer name is another column name. So this denotes the attribute. The address is another column. It is an attribute. So this is an example, student relation. So student is the name of that relation. This is a relation. Okay, this is a relation, and student is the name of the relation, and the attributes or the columns are name, SSN, home phone number, address, office phone, age and GPA. And these are the tuples of this one. So this one is the first tuple. So we have five tuples in it or five rows in it. Okay, so relation. And if we take student and the first row, then it is known as a relation schema. Okay, I think it's now clear. Then domain, like in set theory, here also we have domain. For example, if we have US phone numbers, are set of 10 digits. So if you are entering some data, it should be 10 digit phone number and it should be a valid phone number in the US. So that means it is a domain. Domain means it should be a set of 10 digit numbers for that phone number. So and this domain may have a data type or a format defined for it. Okay, so you should understand what is a domain. So it is a set of some atomic values. Atomic means it is some indivisible values. So social security number, it will have some 6-digit number or 9-digit. If you take Aadhaar number, it will be a 10-digit code and it will be a unique number like that. Name should be a character. Then it is that is known as a domain of that name. Okay. Then another definition, relation. We have already defined relation schema. Now relation, or we call it as relation state, and it is denoted by small letter r of the relation schema r. So this denotes the relation schema, and small r denotes the relation state. It is also denoted by r of r. This means it is a relation state, is a set of n tuples. So if you take this table, then this is known as R of R because we have filled some states. So R of R denotes actually the state of that table or state of that relation. Okay, so this denotes a relation. This whole together is known as a relation. So it contains a set of values. So R of R, it contains set of n tuples. N t1 t2 like that, there will be n number of tuples or n number of rows in it, and each tuple t is an ordered list of n values. So each tuple, if we take each row, it will have t equal to v1 v2 etc, and where each vi will be one I is from 1 to n is an element of domain of ai, or it can be null value. We have already seen what is a null value when we studied attribute. So there is a special kind of value if value is not applicable, and if it is unknown, or if in some other case we will include null in it. If we do not know the phone number of a person, then we simply insert a null value. Okay. So it is an ordered set of values, t, v1, v2, and v, this value is an element of domain of AI. So if we take V1, then it is a domain of A1, first attribute. So first attribute, if it is social security number, it has a domain. So this V1 should be from this domain. It can also be, it's an alternate definition. So a relation R, relation or relation state R of R is a mathematical relation of degree N, and it can be defined like that, this. So R of R is a subset of domain of A1. This is cross product. You have already seen in set theory, there is a cross product. So you know what is A cross B. When you take A equal to 1, 2 and B equal to set AB, then if you take cross product, it will be A cross B, it will be 1A, 1B, then 2A, 2B. So Similarly, if you take the state or if it is filled with data, then R of R will be a subset of this cross product domain of A1. So it can be a cross product of domain of A1 cross domain of A2 cross domain of A2. So this is an example. So if we take this Benjamin Bear, it is inside this domain of A name. Similarly, this is in the domain of SSN. Like that phone number is in the domain of third attribute. Like that it will go on. So if we take the cross product of all this domain, then R of R will be a subset of this cross product. So this is just a formal definition. This is just to understand that in relations, if we form this tuples or rows, each tuple will be from this domain, is an element of this cross product. Okay, it's an element of this cross product. And if we take the whole R of R, then it will be a subset of this cross product. So R, capital R, denotes schema of a relation. R of R, it is a specific value or populated table. We have already seen this term population, populated table or database state. So R of R denotes the state of the table or population of R. And then here R is called the indention of a relation. So when we learned schema in the previous lecture, we have already seen this term indention and extension. So capital R denotes indention of a relation, and small r is also called the extension of a relation. Okay, so this is the schema and this is the database state. At a particular amount of time, what is the data? It is denoted by R of R. So these terms we'll be using throughout the lecture. So that's why we have to know all these terms, what is capital R, what is small r and all. So this is a definition summary what we have learned. This is a formal informal term. So table, it is an informal term. Formally it is known as relation. Column, it is an informal term. We can call it as attribute. Okay, then row, it is an informal term. We call it as tuple. And values in a column will have some domain. Then table definition, we call it a schema of a relation. Table definition is known as schema, that is employee, and the attribute together is known as a schema. Then populated table, if we are filling some data, then it is known as extension, and this schema is also known as indention. Okay, then we will see characteristics of this relation. So ordering of tuples in a relation, so we will see whether there is any order of tuples in a relation. Actually, tuples are not considered to be ordered. There is no ordering among tuples. Any row can appear first. It is not mandatory that the first person, admission number 1, should appear first. Admission number 2 should appear second. There is no ordering in rows. So tuples, there is no ordering. Any row can appear first and second. Okay. So tuples are not considered to be ordered. Then what about ordering of attributes in a relation schema R? So we'll consider the attributes R and the values in to be ordered. So if we are taking a relation schema like this, then each row should be ordered like this. That is, A1 should be have this V1 value. A2, this V2 value should be for attribute A2, like that. Vn value should be for An. So ordering of attributes should be there. It should be considered as ordered value. Then what about values in a tuple? So all values are considered to be atomic or indivisible values. So whatever value we have in a row, it is considered to be atomic. Okay. And also we can have special null values used to represent values that are unknown or inapplicable to certain values. So if you consider this is an example table. So this is a student table. So it's student relation. These are the attributes and these are the tuples, and tuples, and there is no ordering among these tuples. Any row can appear first. Okay. And column, it should be ordered because name, under name only we have to write this big table. And this is an alternate definition. If we want, we can remove this ordering of attributes also. If we can define like this. So if we define each tuple like this, then ordering is not important because we are mentioning the attribute name and also the value. Here attribute name is SSN and the value. Now the same tuple can be written in a different order also, because Here attribute is of different order. Here we are considering first address, comma, the address is written. After that name, comma, and the value is written. Then SSN value. So if you are defining like this, so this is an alternative definition. In this case, ordering is not important. If you are writing like this, ordering is not important. But let us consider that all the columns are ordered. Okay, otherwise it will be confusing to write the attribute name comma like this. Okay, so always remember that it can be considered as ordered. It is not always that. In alternative definition, we can make it unordered also. We can write it like this. So these T, all both these T denote the same row or same tuple. So we'll see some relational model notations that will be used. So a relation schema R is denoted like this. We have already seen this. Then usually uppercase letters like Q, P, capital P, capital Q, capital R denote relation names. So we'll be seeing many theory and we'll be seeing find how to find the key of a relation and all. So we'll be using all this notation. So uppercase letters like PQRS denotes relation names. Okay, relations. Then lowercase letters QRS denotes relation states. That is a populated table is denoted by small letter QRS, maybe sometimes P, small p also. Then letters TUV, usually TUV, WX, W, TUV, W, all this denotes tuples or rows. Okay. So for example, T equal to like this, we can write it like this. So this means it is a tuple. And we can also write like this, T of name. So T of this name equal to this one. And T of SSN, comma, GPA, etc. can be written like this. So it means this value is SSN, 3.25 is GPA and 19 is the age. So we can write like this also in notation. Okay, so that's all about relation formal and informal definitions, and we have also seen the characteristics. So we have to learn all these relations. What is relation schema? What is indention? What is extension? What do you mean by R of R? What is small r? All these things, because we will be using all these terms throughout this subject. Okay, thank you.